Why did Mrs. Tomato turn red? She saw Mr. Green Pea. Watching adventurous movies is always a fun experience. We are always mesmerized by the awesome visual effects. Most of us are aware that they are created by using a green screen while shooting the movie. But ever wondered how this works? And out of all the other colors, why are green-colored screens used mostly? Can we use other colors? Let's find out. Imagine a person who wants to teach some astronomy lessons by showing fancy stuff in the background. All she does is add a green screen in the backdrop. How does this help her? Well, the answer lies in the technique called chroma keying. It's a process carried out by various computer application softwares. What exactly do these softwares do? Let's understand with our example. In our video, we want stars and planets in the background. Currently, the whole background of our video is just green. So we tell the software to remove the green color from each scene in the video. This makes the background transparent. Now, the job is simple. The software fills the transparent background with an astronomical scene. The final result we get is the combination of the character's video footage with the astronomical background. This is the chroma keying technique. It's basically a technique used to remove a specific color from an image and replace it by some other image. Now that we've understood what chroma keying is, can you tell me why the green color is specifically used? Think about it. Well, to know that, let's understand with the situation. Here, instead of the green screen, say we use a brown screen as the background for our character. Now, obviously, in the chroma keying process, we will remove the brown color from the background. Notice what just happened? That's right. When we remove the brown color from the background, the same color tone from our character is also removed. We can now see that the result isn't something what we want. Alright, what if we take this color as our background? Again, in the post-production, we get an absurd result. This gives us a hint, doesn't it? Yes, for the background, we have to choose some contrasting colors that do not affect our skin tone or hair color. And which are those colors that are not contained in our skin tone? The natural skin tone of the human body doesn't have green and blue colors. The same goes with our natural hair color. Do you see any shades of green and blue colors? I doubt it. So by default, green and blue screens are used in the backdrops. But usually, we prefer green screens more often than blue. Why is that? The answer lies in the digital cameras. They are designed in a way we see colors. What does that mean? Our eyes are more sensitive to green color than any other color. And digital cameras have sensors that capture the green color accurately. So, green being highly luminant is easier for computer softwares to identify and remove during post-production. Another reason is that the green screen requires less lighting setup than the blue screen. Also, subjects are likely to wear blue outfits more often than green ones. It's very difficult to avoid blue color outfits. But what if the person wants to wear green outfits? Well, in such rare cases, the blue screen comes to our rescue. Alright, consider this challenging situation. We want to create an action block scene of two characters with some adventurous background. Here, one character is wearing a green outfit, while the other one is in a blue outfit. What should we do here? Do we have to shoot characters with their respective green and blue backgrounds separately and then merge them together during post-production? Or can we use both blue and green screens together to shoot the scene? Or is there any other better way? This is your cue box to explore. Let us know your findings in the comments section below. Do share this video with your friends and press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video. Be curious happy learning.